This is Matt Jasa with part two of the glass cannon. I'm going to start by cleaning up the end of this rod to get rid of any bubbles or scuzz that formed. I'll attach that rod to the end of the wheel. This will be the wheel base for the cannon, what will kind of keep it in place and let it be mobile. Go ahead and pull off the other end of the rod here so I can start melting the other wheel down to get that formed. And technically, since I'm using a torch, you would consider this lamp working, but you can call it glass blowing. It's pretty much the same thing. But one thing about lamp workers, we tend to be very picky about details. So I'm gonna go ahead and swipe off a lot of the scuzz and bubbles and go ahead and make sure that's just a crystal clear surface to start working with. And I'm really just removing the top layer here. So it's not removing too much, just the areas that's been exposed to the atmosphere. I'll start melting down this other side, and I'll have to make sure to get it about the same size as the first wheel was, and then when I push it out, that'll give me the same size disc. And you'll be able to see the white hot heat from the inside of the sphere, which is pretty cool here. The wheel's acting kind of like a lens. And that's a kind of cool thing about glass blowing is anything you make always looks better when it's hot, you know, heated up and emitting light. It's a kind of a cool little show. Again, you'll see these rings that have formed. I'll go ahead and melt those out. And I wish I could show you the pressing process. Like I said before, you'll see that in the previous video, probably the magnifying glass episode 2 would be the best. I do plan to get a second camera eventually here so that you can get a extra angle on what's going on. It's just right now it takes a little bit too long to reset everything up and then having to reheat the project again. Just a little bit extra time consuming. And now with those wheels done, I'm gonna go and punty up on the opposite end and heat up the middle to pull it out. It's good to get the punties very straight along the axis. That way when you pull them out, it pulls out very evenly. And with that center starting to heat up pretty well, you can see the red there. I'm going to go ahead and start pulling pretty hard. Oh, I went ahead and broke the punty right off. And that's something I wanted to point out real quick. It's always good to apply more heat than more force. You know, if you're having to force it a lot, then you might want to just heat it up more. And I haven't had any terrible accidents myself, but the worst one I've heard so far was someone was putting so much force on a rod in one hand that once it broke, it ended up going through their other hand. And that's definitely more of an extreme case. Usually the glass blowing is pretty safe. Little burns, little nicks here and there. And as long as you set up the right safety precautions, you know, to protect your eyes, protect your lungs, then there's not really as much risk once you know what you're doing. I mean, I always say it's much more dangerous to go on the highway than it is to blow glass. Because, you know, you have so many elements of the unknown. You know, other drivers, animals at night, the weather. I mean, here it's just you and the flame. I mean, as long as you know what you're doing, then you should be okay. And I'm just going to use the claw grabbers on one side so that I don't leave any marks that I'll have to clean up. And then clean up the opposite side. And now I believe it's time for the cannonballs. I'll go ahead and start on some clear ones and then do a couple of black ones. I started off by cleaning the end of the rod. It's always good to get that tip clean or else those bubbles and imperfection will kind of cause more impurities as it melts around the surrounding glass. Simple just heat and rotate process. I have it a little bit tilted at an angle just because the rod's kind of thin. It's wanting to drip off. But normally if you just hold it level, it usually works out the best. I'll punty up with a smaller tipped punty. That way it won't leave a large mark. And I was talking about safety equipment a little bit. Gloves, especially Kevlar gloves, are great for protecting your hands from that radiant heat. One thing to note though is the heat, especially like from a large flame, it's not really as intense from the flame as it gets from the project you're working on. And so then something like a 2 or 3 inch marble, you can really put a lot of heat into it, and then it will radiate out so much heat that you'll want to pull your hands back farther and farther away from the marble. And that's something that I've been kind of trying to do as I upgrade my projects bigger and bigger. And now you might have noticed how incredibly bright this is getting. The darker colors, especially black, will radiate out a lot more light. You're definitely going to want to go with a darker shade of glasses, like a number 5 at least. And it also acts a little bit differently than the clear glass. It's a bit better for the cannonball forming just because it's a bit stiffer. The clear will tend to kind of almost run like water if you get it hot enough. But with these opaque colors, they end up to stiffen and kind of almost like a react like a dough almost. And now I'll just heat up that top half and hold it upwards against gravity to have it slump down into a nice spherical shape. For the very last detail, I'll go ahead and make that plunger that they use to get the black powder packed in there. It's got some functionality, some aesthetics. I'm just going to go ahead and roll the sides out a little bit, give it a little bit of shaping, and then see if it actually fits in the cannon, which it looks like it will. But I'm not going to stick it in there while it's hot, just because it could get stuck. And now with it complete, it is time to run the test. Okay, load it up. Blast off. Wow. That smoking gun. Now I'll measure the cannonball's distance between frames to know how fast it's moving.
Like that, perfect. Just like that.
Fire in the hole!
Okay. I don't know if the camera can get that.
Well, it's going pretty fast. Enemy castle, cliffside, bring in the cannon. Begin cannon loading. Quickly before our position is found out. Bring her into range. On my command, fire. Hey, thanks for watching the video. The cannon turned out much better than I thought, and I had a lot of fun shooting it. Let me know what you think in the comment section, and I'll see you in my next video.